So you want to know what it's like to live in Castro Valley, California? Well, that's what we're going to talk about today. So let's get to it. Welcome to the Living in Oakland, California channel. I'm Rich Fleming, your local realtor, and I'm here to teach you everything you need to know about living, working, playing, sleeping, eating, whatever, in Oakland and the rest of the San Francisco East Bay. I get a ton of people who reach out to me with questions about what it's like to live here, how do they transition here, what do they need to know before they get here, and I absolutely love it. That is why I do these videos. So if you got questions, you know what to do. Drop me a text, send me an email, give me a call, whatever works for you. Because when it comes to relocating to Oakland and the rest of the San Francisco East Bay, I got your back. So in today's video, we're gonna talk about Castro Valley, California. And I happen to be in Lake Chabot Regional Park, which is mostly in Castro Valley and partly in Oakland. And it is one of the most popular features of the Castro Valley area. It is a spectacular place to hang out. It's a little bit slow today. I'll do a little bit of a pan around. It's January 2021, so it's a little bit nippy out today. But during the summer months, this place is extremely popular and it's a great place to hang out with the family or just come for a hike by yourself. Enjoy the lake. They have boats you can rent. So it is a spectacular place. So where is Castro Valley located? Well, it is just south of San Leandro in Oakland. It is essentially just east of where highways 580 and 238 merge. So Castro Valley is an unincorporated part of Alameda County, and it has a population of about 65, maybe 70,000 people. We'll have to see what the latest census says. And it covers an area of about 16.5 square miles. So that gives it population density of about 3,900 people per square mile. Now, I mentioned it is an unincorporated area, and what that means is Castro Valley isn't officially a city. It is administered in many aspects by the county of Alameda. Castro Valley happens to be the fifth biggest unincorporated area in California in terms of population. Castro Valley does have its own school district, which I'll talk about a little bit later on, and it has its own sanitary district, which manages the sewers in the area. But for other services, such as building permits, fire and police protection, those are provided by Alameda County. So one of the best things about Castro Valley is it has a wide diversity of feels to its different areas and neighborhoods. That unincorporated aspect of Castro Valley means that in some areas you have homes that are very small next to homes that are very large. You have areas where there are still ranches in Castro Valley, and then you have very suburban tract homes in Castro Valley. You can get a little bit of it all in Castro Valley depending on what you're looking for. So the commercial hub of Castro Valley is along Castro Valley Boulevard, and it is the downtown section of Castro Valley. Now, Castro Valley is unique to a lot of the other towns in this general area that it does not have a lot of commercial development. So there are no significant large employers other than Sutter Hospital, which is here in town, in Castro Valley. It is very much a bedroom and small ranch community. So what's the housing like in Castro Valley? Well, it is across the board. I mean, you can literally find everything from trailer parks in Castro Valley to mansions located on ranches in Castro Valley. It just depends on what meets your needs and your economic capabilities. Now, on the west and central parts of Castro Valley, the housing stock tends to be older and very diverse. And that diversity in housing comes from the fact that it is an unincorporated area of the county. So you can literally have a two bedroom, one bathroom home next door or a few feet down the street from a four bedroom, 3.5 bathroom house. The housing stock was built by a lot of individuals there was not necessarily a grand plan for building housing in Old Town Castor Valley. Now, when you look at the easterly side of Castor Valley, you do find way more of the more modern planned housing communities out there. There are tons of opportunities for people who are looking for that type of housing in Castor Valley, especially in the Eastward End. Prices in Castor Valley can range from maybe a low of about $500,000 to $600,000 for a two-bedroom home to as much as about $1.5 to $2 million for a larger home with some land around it. Rental prices, they can vary significantly. I'm going to say you're going to be able to find a one-bedroom apartment for probably about $1,600 to $1,700 as a start, and that can go up probably to about $2,500 to $3,000, depending on, once again, where you're looking at, what amenities the building has. So what are some of the primary factors that has caused Castro Valley's popularity to swell over the last 5 or 10 years? Well, I think there are three of them. First, geography. Castro Valley has excellent access to Highway 580, which essentially runs through Castro Valley. You are not far from Highways 880, and it makes it pretty simple to get out to Pleasanton and Silicon Valley. And you can also drive to Oakland and San Francisco pretty easily from here. Furthermore, Castro Valley has a BART station. So at least in pre-COVID times, it was easy to catch BART, get into the city quickly for work. The second factor is its access to the outdoors. Castro Valley has a lot of parks and it is a very pretty and scenic area to live in. It also has access to Lake Chabot, which is part of the East Bay Regional Park District's offerings. So it is very easy to get there from downtown Castro Valley. It's about 5 minutes drive. As a matter of fact, I'll take you out there now. So as I did mention earlier, Lake Chabot is one of the most popular parks in the East Bay Regional Park District. And let me just give you a little pan around again. It is a beautiful park. I'm here in January 2021, so it's a little bit nippy out, not a ton of people out, but during the spring, summer, fall months, this place is very popular. You can rent boats, paddle boats, small motor boats, kayaks, enjoy the lake. Plenty of picnic areas out here, great for the family, great for hikes on your own. So Lake Chabot, construction on it was finished in 1875. And the primary purpose of it was to be the primary water source for the East Bay back then, primarily Oakland, Berkeley, and some of the smaller towns back then. You actually could not access Lake Chabot for about 90 years. They had sealed off access to it and there was no public access to it. And that ended in, I believe, about the 1960s. So the lake still acts as a emergency backup source of water for the East Bay, but its real primary focus and purpose is really a park that people can enjoy. So if you get a chance, come out to Lake Chabot. It is absolutely beautiful out here. The third factor that has really made Castro Valley way more appealing to families is that its school district is very well regarded. So the Castro Valley Unified School District has about 9,000 students and it has about a dozen schools, at least traditional schools, and it has become a very strong school district, a school district people desire to be in. So when you put those three factors together, Castro Valley's popularity has gone up significantly. So that's our quick look at Castro Valley, California. It is a beautiful place to live, very peaceful, really has that small town feeling. But to be honest, if you're looking for excitement, Castro Valley is not the place you want to be. There really isn't a whole lot that goes on here. There's not much as far as dining is concerned or dining culture. There is not significant nightlife here. It is really designed for families and people who want peace, quiet, and a beautiful place to live. So if you do have questions about Castro Valley, or anywhere else in the San Francisco East Bay, you know what to do. Drop me a text, give me a call, send me an email, whatever works for you. Because when it comes to helping you transition to the San Francisco East Bay, I got your back. So if you found this video helpful, hit that thumbs up so YouTube knows the show this video to other people like yourself. Hit that subscribe button, hit that bell notification so you know each and every time I drop a new video, and I'll catch you in the next video.